Hi, I'm Brandon Monk, and I'm a wildlife veterinarian for the California Department of Fish and Wildlife. I'm also a hunter, and I understand how chronic wasting disease could threaten our deer and elk populations and our hunting opportunities. Today, I'm going to show you how to extract lymph nodes from a deer or elk for chronic wasting disease testing. Removing the lymph nodes involves cutting into the neck. To do this, position the deer on its back with its head and neck fully extended. If the deer has antlers, you'll want to position it so the ears and the antlers clear the table or truck bed. Next, let's identify landmarks for making your cut. First, you need to find the end of the jawbone. At the end of the jawbone, right here, you can feel the trachea. Find the widest part of the trachea. This is the larynx, and it should start about where the jawbone ends. You can also find it by running your finger down the underside of the neck, along the midline. Once you pass that last bump, you're at the end of the larynx. This is where you'll cut. Holding the head and neck straight, use a sharp knife and make a stab incision. Start off cutting straight down through the trachea. Once you've cut through the trachea, insert your index finger into the windpipe and pull up and back towards the nose. Continue cutting, angling back towards the base of the ears. Okay, let's take a moment and identify what we're looking at here. The retropharyngeal lymph nodes are here on either side of the midline. These are what we're looking for. There are other structures that could obscure or be mistaken for lymph nodes, including the salivary glands, muscle, and fat. You can tell it's a lymph node by feeling it. It should be a discrete, semi-firm structure that slips through your fingers when gently pinched and pulled. Most of the time, you should be able to work the lymph node out with your fingers. Gently dissect around the lymph node with your index finger until you can grasp it and pull it free from the surrounding tissues. You can also cut the lymph node out using a knife and tweezers. Here we have retropharyngeal lymph nodes from three different deer. Lymph nodes can vary in size, shape, and color between animals. In general, they are semi-firm, kidney-shaped, approximately nickel to quarter-sized, and tan to light red in color. To confirm you have a lymph node, bisect the sample along the short axis. You should be able to see some discrete, lighter-colored areas around the outside edge of the cut surface. These are the lymphoid follicles, and that's how you know it's a lymph node. If this were muscle, the color would be uniform throughout, and if it were salivary gland, it'd look like chewed bubblegum with multiple discrete lobules. The California Department of Fish and Wildlife specimen kit will look something like this. You'll have a larger resealable specimen bag, and inside you should have two sample bags and a data card. As cleanly as possible, prepare the specimen bags. Tear off the top part of the bag above the yellow tabs along the perforated line, and use the white tabs to open the bag. Place one lymph node in each sample bag. To properly seal the bag, roll the yellow wired tabs down, squeezing as much air out of the bag as possible as you go. Roll it down at least 2 to 3 times, then fold the yellow tabs towards the middle of the bag. If done properly, this sample bag should lay flat with only the lymph nodes bulging out. Next, don't forget to fill out both sides of the data card. You'll need to know your Go ID and tag number, both of which can be found on your hunting tag. Finally, place the sample bags into the resealable portion of the specimen bag and secure it. Insert the completed data card into the outside pocket of the specimen bag. The specimen bag can be refrigerated if you are submitting it immediately, or frozen if submitting it at a later date. Once your samples are properly packaged, you have a few options for getting them to CDFW. If dropping them off within a day or two, they can be refrigerated. If it will be more than a few days, then store them frozen. You can drop them off at your nearest CDFW regional office during normal business hours. If you're not sure where an office is located, you can find them listed at wildlife.ca.gov/regions. You can find additional sampling and drop-off options at wildlife.ca.gov/CWD. This is also where you'll go to find your results. After samples have been collected and submitted, please be patient. Testing can take up to a few months to complete. Thank you for watching this video. Should you have additional questions, please email us at cwd@wildlife.ca.gov.